Okay, so this next question is in reference to the liver and gallbladder flush by Andreas Moritz that we teach. And it goes, I didn't do the liver gallbladder flush, bowel issues, and I made some bad choices this week with sugar. Will my symptoms be worse being though I didn't detox? Also, can I do a colonic during the water fast, and how often should I do an enema? So, with the liver and gallbladder flush, the point of the flush is to help prepare you for your fasting. That's the reason why we tell you guys to do it. If you are looking to do some long-term fasting, I think this individual is in our 21-day fasting challenge. If you're doing some long-term fasting and you don't do the liver gallbladder flush, that's okay. However, what makes me nervous is the fact that you have been, you know, making some bad choices with your eating habits and with sugar and things of that nature. You can obviously get through a lot of these things. You can will yourself through it. But one of the reasons why a lot of us are here in the community looking for support is because we have low motivation or low willpower, right? Or we have a high food addiction. So we don't really want to play these games when it comes to a long-term fast. I highly recommend that you all, if you're going to do a long-term fast, you do a proper preparation. It's okay to not be perfect, but if you know you're way off the course, it's a good idea to keep practicing till you get, you know, more in alignment and then pursue your long-term fast. But yes, if you go into a long-term fast without doing the proper preparation, your detox symptoms are definitely going to be worse, okay? Now, once you are in the mix of things, can you do a colonic during the fast or an enema? Yes, you can. I don't recommend overdoing it, right? So if you're doing like one enema or one colonic per week, that would probably be okay. You can actually talk to your colon hydrotherapist about frequency and what would be safe to do. But it's not something you want to be doing like daily, all right? But if you just want, okay, I've been fasting for a while, I feel like I should do it. One indicator is if you feel really ill for a period of time, maybe it's a day or even more, and you feel really, really ill, oftentimes it's because you need to move the bowels. So if you know your bowels have not moved and you're feeling really ill, this might be a good opportunity or a good sign that it's time to do an enema or a colonic. So hopefully that is helpful for you.